Okay. So let us start with our session. This is a session for your upcoming JIPMER exam. So today I'll be discussing one important topic of MTP and abortion. All the medical legal issues related to your medical termination of pregnancy and criminal abortions. So before starting the session, let me just give you a briefing about the schedule of the coming week in Unacademy live sessions. As far as YouTube sessions are concerned, okay. So in this coming week, starting from today, Sunday, every day at 6 p.m., 7 p.m. and 8:30 p.m., you will have AIIMS related discussions, then PGI exam related discussions and JIPMER exam related discussion every day. Okay, in the evening. So the PGI schedule is fixed at 6 p.m. from Monday to Sunday every week, every day in this coming week. Okay, then your AIIMS schedule in YouTube sessions have been fixed at 7 p.m. where all the different educators will be discussing their different subjects areas. And like today, we have started with JIPMER session. Today is Sunday, so I have started with my session. And so on. It will continue for 1 week till 30th of April. Okay. So in your PGI MCQ discussion, there will be high yield topics discussion. In your AIIMS area, there will be image based MCQ discussion. And in JIPMER, we will be discussing some high yield of different subjects by different educators. Okay. So let us start with the session now. So you all must have read this Indications of Abortion according to our MTP Act 1971. Okay. So these indications are your social indications, eugenic indications, therapeutic and humanitarian indications. Easily can be remembered with the help of this mnemonic called SETH, S-E-T-H, social, eugenic, therapeutic and humanitarian. So what do you mean by social indication? When the pregnancy has occurred due to contraceptive failure, okay, this forms your social indications of termination of pregnancy according to our MTP Act. Then eugenic indications means when there is severe risk of any physical or mental disease to fetus itself. So MTP is allowed in such condition. Then when there is risk to the life of female, this is said to be therapeutic indications. Yes, MTP is again allowed. And when the pregnancy has occurred due to offense of rape, then this is also allowed. MTP is allowed under humanitarian grounds. So these are your four indications for medical termination of pregnancy. Now, first I will discuss your MTP Act of 1971, then I will discuss your recent MTP amendment bill also, okay, and I will compare what are the areas which are going to change in your upcoming MTP bill 2020. So this is fixed in the bill itself. This is also same in the bill. For MTP, consent of female only is required. But the age of the female should be more than 18 years. Okay. Age of the female should be more than 18 years. Then who can perform MTP? These four group of doctors can perform MTP. Which four group of doctors? First one is any registered medical practitioner who has got 6 month house job experience in obstetrics department. So who is the RMP or registered medical practitioner? Any MBBS doctor whose degree is registered in his or her state medical council, you become a RMP after your internship. If your degree is registered, you become a registered medical practitioner. You get a license to practice medical science. Okay. Then second group of doctors who can perform MTP is any RMP who has 1 year experience in obstetrics department. 1 year experience should be of 1 year. Then another type of doctor who can do your MDPs? Yes, MD and DGO. MD and diploma degree in obs gyne. They can obviously do MDP. And fourth category of doctors is any RMP who has done 25 MDPs. 25 MDP experience, out of which 5 were done independently by the doctor. 5 should have been done independently by the doctor. Okay. So, up to what period this MDP was allowed according to our MDP Act 1971? Up to 12 weeks pregnancy, opinion of one doctor was needed, and any of these 4 can do, used to do your MDP up to 12 weeks, any of the 4, okay, which we have just discussed. But for a pregnancy more than 12 to 20 weeks, opinion of 2 doctors is needed, and only these first, second and third group of doctors can do MDP between 12 to 20 weeks. This was the thing earlier, okay. Now, what has changed in the bill? In the MDP amendment bill, till now it is a bill because it has not been passed by both the houses. Okay. Once it is passed by both the houses, every bill is signed by the president and then it becomes an act. So the full name of this act will be MDP Amendment Act 2020. Okay. Once it is signed by the president. So, according to this bill, a pregnancy may be terminated within 20 weeks with the opinion of a single RMP. Only one doctor opinion is needed for MDP up to 20 weeks. So, basically the duration of pregnancy coverage is increased in this amendment bill. Then what else is changed? The duration further has been increased up to 24 weeks. So between 20 to 24 weeks, the opinion of 2 RMPs is required. Here the opinion of 2 RMPs is required for MDP. This is the significant change. Now compare this. Here there was for up to 12, one doctor, between 12 to 22 or more than 2. But here up to 20 weeks of gestation. That means 5 months of pregnancy. For first 5 months of pregnancy, only one doctor opinion is needed for MDP. This is the major amendment. And between 20 to 24 weeks, opinion of 2 doctors is needed. Now here also there is a catch. For up to 24 weeks MDP, this will apply only to specific categories of a woman, as prescribed by central government. So the catch here is, government, after making an act, they make rules so as to how a particular act will be implemented. So implementation criterias or the rules of MDP will be given by the government later on, once the bill becomes an act. Okay. So which specific categories will be, for which specific categories MDP up to 24 weeks will be allowed, this will be discussed by government later on. Okay. This will be discussed by government later on. Just a minute, I will change the pen. Pen is actually not working. So this is the amendment in the new bill of 2020. Another important thing in this amendment is, just a minute, what is happening? There will be constitution of a new medical board. Now, what will be the role of this medical board? This has also been clearly written in the revised bill that the upper limit of termination of pregnancy will not apply in cases where it is due to diagnosis of substantial fetal abnormalities. So basically, they want to say that for eugenic indications, now the role will be played by a medical board. So becomes a potential question for any upcoming exam. So for any eugenic condition, who will play a role according to this bill? A medical board. So the question can be framed like this. All the following will be members of medical board for eugenic indications except. So what are the members? A gynecologist. Second member is a pediatrician. Third is a radiologist or sonologist. And fourth member can be any other member as recruited by central government. Just like your Transplantation Act, we have brain stem death certification team. So here also a team of doctors will be made, constituting of a gynecologist, a pediatrician, a radiologist or sonologist, and any other member as notified by central and state governments. Okay, as per MTP rules, which will come later on once the act is properly formulated. Okay, so these are the new things. Now, because the abnormalities in the fetus will be diagnosed by a medical board, earlier this was given by the medical profession, any doctor, it was taken into account, but now the diagnosis will be done by a team of medical doctors. A medical board will be formed according to this new amendment bill 2020. So these are the significant changes. Two important things to be remembered. The duration of upper limit has been increased to 24 weeks. So one doctor opinion is needed for up to 20 weeks. Two doctors are needed for 20 to 24 weeks MTP. Second thing is, for 20 to 24 weeks MTP, it will be applicable to specific categories of women. And this specific category will be specified by the central government in the MTP rules. And for this MTP between 20 to 24 weeks, if there are fetal abnormalities, then it will be diagnosed by a team of doctors. There will be a medical board as per our revised act. Okay. And this line is also very important in this revised bill. The norms for the RMP whose opinion is required at different gestational age shall be prescribed by the rules. So till now they have not made it clear which doctors will be eligible to do MTP. So what we have discussed just before, we have discussed this, who can perform MTP. This is as per MTP Act of 1971. But as per the revised bill, who can do MTP? This is not clear still. This will be cleared in MTP rules, which will be made once this act is into effect. Okay, so keep this. This is the third change which you should keep in mind. So remember these three important amendments. The upper limit of MTP is increased. Then there will be a medical board to diagnose eugenic indications. Plus the norms for the RMP is not clear. Whose opinion will matter? But yes, obviously MD or DGO will be there, because these people can easily do MTP. For other RMPs, I think the experience thing will be increased or it will be, get some change. But it will be cleared in the MTP rules itself, not before that. Okay. So earlier, any doctor who has done 6 month house job in any government institution, they used to do MTP. Any doctor, any RMP who has 1 year experience in any private hospital, in obs-gyne department, they can do MTP according to the previous act. But the current status will be cleared by the government in the MTP rules. And once these rules come into effect, I will keep a session and I will inform you. Okay, so after this MTP thing, let us see few things about abortion. So basically, any abortion which is done outside the purview of MTP Act will be called as criminal abortion. So what do you mean by criminal or illegal abortion? This simply means any abortion done outside the purview of MTP Act is called illegal or criminal abortion. And to deal with such cases, we have these sections of law from 312 to 316 IPCs. They deal with criminal abortions. So how criminal abortions can be done? What are the methods usually used? This is a repeat question. Which one of the following is the ecbolic? There the correct answer was ergot. So methods usually used for criminal abortion are ecbolics can be used. So what are ecbolics? Good evening to all of you. Good evening. Good evening. Ecbolics are substances which increase uterine contraction and helps in expulsion of the fetus, like ergot, quinine, strychnine and nitrobenzol. Okay. Then another thing which can be used for criminal abortion is iminagogues can be used. Now what are iminagogues? Substances which increase the menstrual flow. So by increasing the menstrual flow, what you can increase is the expulsion of the fetus. So this can be achieved by use of borax or your sanguinarin poison. Sanguinarin poison. Then people also use irritants of genitourinary tract like turpentine oil or cantharides. That is different thing. Quinine is given when it is given in overdose. it can act as ecbolics. Okay. So in therapeutic dosing, it will treat malaria. But in overdosing, it can act as ecbolic and can help in criminal abortions. Okay, Parag. But there are some systemic poisons which even at sublethal dose, they are lethal to your fetus. Like unripe fruit of papaya, unripe fruit of pineapple. These are systemic poison. They are poisonous to the fetus even at sublethal dose. Sublethal dose for the female. But it becomes lethal for the fetus. Like unripe fruit of papaya, pineapple, seeds of carrot. These are systemic poisons which induce abortions. Okay. So let me simplify your that area, IPC area related to criminal abortions. Let us first discuss 312 and 313 and try to understand what is the difference between these two IPC sections. So 312 says any criminal abortion with consent of the female, like a female is getting her abortion done herself and she is saying I have given my own consent for this abortion. So obviously when the female does the abortion herself, but the abortion becomes illegal or criminal when it is done till date, if it is done of a fetus more than 20 weeks, the abortion becomes illegal. So even if it is done by the female can be booked under which IPC? Answer will be 312. Okay. Second scenario. The husband has forced a female to give her consent and forceful abortion was being done. So all the doctors, husband and all people who have forced a female to give her consent, they will be booked under 312. Okay. Now the female did not give her consent, but then also criminal abortion was being done. So by the word criminal abortion, we mean abortion, what is not being followed? MTP Act is not being followed. So when it is done without the consent of a female more than 18 year old, then the FIR will be lodged under 313. Now important thing to understand here is, other than 312, all the offenses are cognizable and they are triable in Sessions Court. But your 312 IPC, it is a non-cognizable offense and the trial can be done by a first class judicial magistrate. So out of 312 to 316, 312 is the only IPC section which is non-cognizable. Rest all 312, 313 to 316, they are cognizable and the trial is done in sessions court. But 312 is one offense for which trial can be done by first class judicial magistrate. Okay. Now see the scenario. What is the maximum power of first class judicial magistrate? Maximum power of first class judicial magistrate is 3 years. This you must have read. Maximum power of first class judicial magistrate is 3 years for imprisonment. Maximum power of second class is 1 year. First class 3 years, CJN 7 years, chief judicial magistrate. Okay. Now see the scenario. The first scenario is death of the female has not occurred during abortion and the fetus did not show quickening. So quickening is movement of fetal parts between 16 to 20 weeks of gestation. 20 weeks in a primipare and 16 weeks in a multipare. And what is quickening? Movement of fetal body parts felt by the female. So if quickening is not present, means if the pregnancy for a primipare is less than 20 weeks, the punishment given under 312 means consent of the female is there. The punishment is either 3 years imprisonment or fine or both. Okay. But if quickening is present, now the punishment increases. Now the punishment increases. So these are special scenarios where even first class judicial magistrate can give higher punishment. Okay. Now, what was 313? 313 was a situation where consent of the female was not there. Okay. Abortion was being done, which was illegal, without consent of the female. So here the punishment is either 10 years or life imprisonment plus fine. So see the difference. Quickening is basically applicable for your 312 IPC. Okay. It is basically applicable for 312. So this is also an update that quickening is applicable mainly with 312 IPC. That means if an offense is done with the consent of the female and if quickening is present, the punishment will increase. Not for 313. Okay. Not for 313. So in 313, whether quickening is present or not, the punishment is either 10 years or life imprisonment plus fine. But yes, if during abortion death of the female has occurred, now here also whether the fetus is quickened or not, this is not taken into account. So if the death of the female has occurred during abortion, which IPC section will come into play? 314. And here the punishment is along with imprisonment, fine is there, 10 years plus fine. If there was consent of the female, but if it was done without consent and death of the female has occurred, now the punishment can extend to life imprisonment along with fine. So 312, simply speaking, is abortion with consent. 313 is abortion without consent. 314 is death of the female during abortion. 314 is death of the pregnant female during abortion. And we have seen the punishment. Now comes 315. This says any intentional act. And what was the intention? To prevent a child being born alive or to cause a live birth child to die just after birth. So how can birth of a child be prevented? For this, let us take an example. Suppose a female who is 28 weeks pregnant comes to a doctor and tells a story that this pregnancy was done by her boyfriend, but now the boyfriend is not marrying her, so she does not want this child to be kept in her womb. The doctor does the craniotomy and craniocentesis. So So what was that craniotomy? An intentional act to prevent child being born alive. Now the doctor will be punished under which law? Yes, 315. And this will also cover, suppose killing of a live birth child is being done. So this will cover this also, okay? This aspect also. Punishment is 10 years or fine or both. But here there is one catch. Killing of a person of any age in India is murder unless proved otherwise. What is the query, Arun? After death, how will we know that female has given consent or not, sir? Okay. In this, no. Death of the female has occurred during abortion. The consent was present with the doctor. The doctor gave the consent to the police. That female consented for her abortion. But later on, it was found that the female was 26 weeks pregnant. So yes, it becomes criminal abortion. Consent of the female was there. So now the punishment will be this one. Got it, Arun? Consent had been given by mother before. Yes. Students have only solved your query. Very good. Darshil Thakkar. Very good. So where was I? Killing of a person of any age in India is murder unless proved otherwise. So if you get a question like, killing of a newborn child will be punishable under, and if you get options like both options 302 and 315, now the best answer will be 302. Punishment for murder for the accused to be given. Killing of a person of any age is murder unless proved otherwise. Yes, in the FIR 315 will also be applicable, but punishment is always given for the according to the higher IPC. So what is the punishment in 302? Minimum life imprisonment, maximum death sentence. So yes, see the difference. In 315, the punishment is 10 years or fine or both. So yes, higher quantum of punishment is in 302. And 302 says, killing of a person of any age, whether it is a newborn, is murder. So now the best answer will be 302. This is a repeat question of your DNB exam. Killing of a newborn will be punishable under. So out of 302 and 315, best answer will be 302. Okay. Now come to 316. 316 says, a person took a knife and he was going to kill a pregnant female. Okay. This was the intention of the person. But death of someone else occurred. The knife went into your uterus and it caused death of a quick unborn fetus. A fetus who has achieved 16 to 20 weeks of pregnancy. This was the age of the fetus. So now the intention was not to kill the fetus. The mother has been saved. But then also the accused will be punished under 316. And the punishment is 10 years plus fine. 10 years imprisonment. Plus fine. So these are your sections applicable with criminal abortion. Okay, 312 to 316 IPCs. And this is the special class which I am taking in an Unacademy platform. On 2nd of April and 5th of April, I have taken two sessions for your forensic psychiatry and AIIMS new pattern MCQs. On 10th of April is the upcoming session related to forensic ballistics. Okay. From 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. And coming to Unacademy Plus courses. We have different batch course and plus courses going on continuously every month. Like since January, a foundation batch course is running for covering all the 19 subjects. Then there is a separate batch course for medical MCQs marathon course, which is covering your new pattern questions of AIIMS, and it will be helpful in your PGI also, in your NIMHANS also. Then there is a system wise batch course like respiratory medicine, CVS medicine, and all the subjects which can be covered from those systems. Those educators are there to teach you. And there are separate batch, separate courses for each and every subject also. Every month new courses are launched. So those who want to join, they can use the code of mine, Dr. Vishwajit-YT. Okay. So see you all in next sessions. And this is the upcoming session of mine in Unacademy platform in the form of a special live class. So when you will visit my profile, you will come to know. You will get the, if you follow my profile, you will get the notification automatically. You will be notified. So hi, I hope the session was good. So see you all later on. So it's time to end the session. Bye bye.